Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen of Frag Nation Daily here, and today we are taking a look at the eBlue Cobra. This is a mid-grade gaming keyboard from eBlue, one of our newest lines of reviews that we're doing. And I gotta tell you, this keyboard actually was pretty impressive. I'm actually using it as my day-to-day keyboard currently. And that's gotta say something, because usually I use a huge SteelSeries Apex with all the MX keys and all that stuff. But this is actually getting the job done, and I do like it. It does have a few things that I don't like, but overall, it's got I'd say a 90% like rating for me right now. Plus, the illumination on this thing is just beautiful. We're gonna hook this up and show you what it looks like. Should be showing down at the bottom of the video. But overall, this keyboard did some great things. Let's give you a close-up of it and show you exactly what the Cobra is. Ladies and gentlemen, so starting off, the eBlue Cobra looks like your basic gaming keyboard, and for the most part, it is. It's just a regular keyboard. It has the 10 touch number system right here. Everything's pretty standard. However, the illumination that you saw on the side and the illumination through these keys is quite beautiful. It's got a nice font that's easy to read and easy to see. As well as these keys, they don't have a white coating paint to where they can scratch off and rub off. You can see my WASD keys have had heavy use. You can see them starting to shine where the gloss is coming off, but there's no fade whatsoever to the actual key itself. I believe it's cut underneath so that the illumination shines through and you don't get that wear that you get on some keyboards. Now, flipping over to the back, the Cobra is well put together. You can see it feels pretty sturdy. You can see, like I was saying, it's multiple screws all over the place to give you that really sturdy feel. There's no wobble to this keyboard. And it has a unique kickstand here for you guys that like a little slope to your... There we go. A little slope to your bar here to give you that kind of extra ergonomical feel. Now, speaking of the kickstands, you also have dual layered kickstands here. It's not like the other ones where you just replace them or whatever. You choose which level you want. This is the higher raise. And you can see right there, you got a nice good tilt along with the flip down here. You can flip that on or off depending on how you like your keyboard to feel. Now, one thing I didn't like about this keyboard is it's missing a right Windows key. I don't like these FN keys. There's quite a few games now that require you to, or give you the option to, assign your keys different places and stuff. And I like to use my right Windows key in a lot of games, especially Arma. It does have a left right here, and it does work properly. However, this FN key does me no good. I don't like it. But that's kind of taken away from what this actually is. This is, like I said, your mid-grade gaming keyboard. You don't have a ton of money to spend on maybe, you know, something in the $150 range or whatever. This keyboard is going to get you through, and it's lit beautifully. It's really hard to find lighted keyboards that play well, game well, and work well. So I was really happy that they put as much effort into this keyboard as they did. The next thing that I want to talk about is the key press. The key press on these keys is fairly well. However, I would like a more tactile response. They're kind of soft mash keys. I'm not really sure exactly what you call that. I know they're not mechanical, that's for a fact. But they have a really soft press, and sometimes I accidentally press it and I don't really feel it because it's got such a light press on it. And as well, the WASD keys do not have bumps on them, so it's really hard to find your return. The standard keys are bumped, the F and the J, both bumped here. But there's no bump, maybe like on a Steel Series or a Razor, where you have bumps on your WAS and D, so you can find your position if your hands are underneath the keyboard rest or whatnot. So, all in all, what do we think about the Cobra? The Cobra is definitely a good budget gaming keyboard, especially not overlooking the fact that it has a braided cable as well. Again, this company doing braided cables on pretty much every product we've seen so far, and we really, really like that. So, all in all, I like the Cobra. I would recommend this if you're in the market for a gaming keyboard on a budget. Thank you guys so much at eBlue for letting us check this out. And stay tuned. We've got some more reviews coming for you guys. See you next time.